afternoon. I just want to share about what I'm feeling inside of me, that I know God is ministering to me, and He just wants all of us to get ready for His coming. So I'm reading Matthew 25, and it says, "Then the kingdom of heaven shall be likened unto 10 virgins who took their lampstands and went out to meet the bridegroom. Now 5 of them were wise and 5 were foolish. And those who were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamp. But while the bridegroom was delayed, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight a cry was heard, 'Behold, the bridegroom is coming, go out to meet him.'" Now God is ministering to me and saying that we are slumbering and sleeping. If we want to be like the 5 wise ones, we have to have oil in our lamps, meaning that we have to be spiritually filled in order to be with the bridegroom. And if we don't have spiritually filled, it's going to be hard on us, because He's at the door. I've heard it only a few nights back. I think it was today's Tuesday. I heard Him Monday morning, in the morning, coming in the morning hours. God is at the door. That's the whisper I heard in my ear. And then, like 2 weeks back, Friday, around midday time, I was asleep. And then I heard, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." And within that same week earlier, I think it was a Tuesday, I had a dream that a Rasta man was shouting, "Hail, the King is coming." So all these things are lining up, that God is giving us a warning and He's telling us to get ready. And the sermons that I've been preaching in church, it's these same things about the kingdom of God and His return. And as I continue to read, "Then those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said to the wise, 'Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out.' But the wise answered, saying, 'No, lest there should be enough for us and you. But go rather to those who sell and buy yourselves.' And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding, and the door was shut." So God is giving us enough time. He's delaying, because if you remember in verse 5, it says, "But while the bridegroom was delayed, they all slumbered and slept." So while God is delaying at this time, because we know that since Jesus died and He rose again, they've been preaching that He's coming back. We heard that He is coming back. He is coming back. And now we're in 2018 and we're still hearing He's coming back. And it's true, He is coming back. But this is why He's delaying, so that His message can be preached around the world, so that His children could be saved and Satan will not have the opportunity to snatch them. You know, and He said, "The kingdom of heaven is at hand. So we gotta get our acts together and repent of our sins and ask God for all forgiveness and to just be with Him. Just try to be with Christ. And as it continues saying, afterwards, the other virgins came also, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But He answered and said, assuredly I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour in which the Son of Man is coming. For the kingdom of heaven is like a man traveling from a far country, who called his own servants and delivers his goods to them. So you see, the word is speaking very clearly. While the five wise ones were ready, the foolish ones had to go looking to people to help them, to pray with them, to, you know, to repent and all these things while it was late. They waited the last moment. Just like a lot of us are going to wait the last moment when Jesus is going to be here, and we're going to hear that sound of the trumpet, and we're going to hear that shout, and we're going to hear the bridegroom is here, and we're going to wait at the last moment then to say, help me fix my life, help, pray for me, ask God to forgive me. You're going to beg in God. But you see what He told the foolish ones? And it says in 10, and while they went to buy, the bridegroom came. You see, this is when they're looking to go. This is when a lot of people are going to run to go to church and all these things. But it's not at the last moment. You can't run into the church for the last moment. God is not going to look at the last moment. What were you doing all the time? All the time, partying, drinking, smoking, having fun. Sometimes you used to go to church, but you weren't serious with God. We call them churchgoers. Sometimes you just want to just go on church on a Sunday because you know that you're not a Hindu, you're not a Muslim, but you call yourselves Christians. But what kind of Christians are you? And while they went in to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding, and the door was shut. And a lot of people is going to be left behind, because when Jesus comes, it's not to wait on anybody. He knows who's going to be there, who's going to be ready. He knows. So no matter what you try to do, to try to say, well, look, I'm in church, a church building, cannot save you. God knows your heart. God knows everything you do, every minute of the day. And if we don't get ourselves together, it's going to be real rough. It's going to be real tough for us to enter. So I'm pleading with you, please, let us get ourselves together. God is near, He's at the door, He's coming. Don't look at nobody else and what they're doing. Don't even follow the world, what the world is doing. It cannot save us, but just look to Jesus. He is the author and finisher of our faith. And it's so sad to know, you know, we think things so lightly. A lot of us don't even believe in Jesus. And a lot of us don't even believe that He's coming back, even though we call ourselves Christians. And I'm hurt, and I really like this message to reach your heart, so that no one is perfect, that we all make mistakes, but it's okay, because if we don't go through things, we can't come through, but we can by the blood of the Lamb. He's a forgiver. God is our forgiver. But we gotta stay clean. We can't come to Christ today and say, Lord, wash me for my sins. Forgive me. Have mercy. I repent. And then next week or next month, we're gone again in the same things. The enemy is going to come and tempt us, but we got to break free. We got to fight hard. It's not easy. Get baptized. Free yourself in the kingdom. Free yourself from darkness. Free yourself from every chain. Generational curses. Only God can do that through Jesus Christ. Give your life to Christ wholeheartedly. I know why I'm telling you this. I just feel like if Jesus is really close, so close in coming back for his people, and he said he's coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle. So just asking you guys to just please do the right thing. Please. To God be the glory and great things he has done. I pray today that this word would minister to your heart and that you would do the right thing. In Jesus' name.